Hey everybody, it's Jeff Lafferty, and it's time for another show. Still don't have a name for it, but, you know, it's an ArtCast type thing. Number 14 got past the horrible bad luck 13, so that's a good thing. But, hope things are going well for everybody. They're going pretty good for me. Working here on the Wolverine commission. Actually, don't know how much drawing I'm going to be doing in this one, because this one might not be a super long video, because I'm going to have to run my hair dryer and do all kinds of stuff like that. So kind of thinking I might just kind of cut this one short, but definitely wanted to keep my streak going and get a video out. Appreciate all the comments. Been getting really awesome, nice comments that are really cool. A lot of people saying I'm inspiring them. Some people, you know, saying I'm inspiring them to sell and stuff, and I'm just like humbled by that. I really think that's super cool if I can have some kind of positive impact in people's lives, you know. So I really appreciate that. And I hope it works out for you guys. And I know I've been getting some questions, but I don't know. I'm getting so many comments that I just can't really keep up with them. And I have to draw so much that that's just what takes up most of my time, you know. And even doing these videos too, you know, the point of it was to kind of, I don't know what the point of it was, but it was kind of like, I don't know. I don't want to say it was just to promote my auctions, because that really wasn't what it was. But it was just kind of like, you know, me kind of doing what I don't know, just, well, I was trying to get resurrect my art videos, actually, without having to do any editing and stuff, so. But I think once you start talking, you almost open up a can of worms, you know. Because people kind of start to associate, you know, with you and get to be your friends online and stuff. And that's super cool. I really like that. But, man, it can get overwhelming sometimes, you know, with some of the comments and stuff. So, but, yeah, I appreciate it at any rate. Keep them coming. I've been putting up a commission auction on eBay. That's worked really well lately. And I sold two of them now, actually. One I haven't done yet. That just sold last night, but let me show you guys some art. This was the last one I sold, which is, this character is called Baby Doll, I think, from that Sucker Punch movie, which is a really cool movie. It's for a guy named Brian. He bought like a ton of art from me. From way back in the day. He might have actually bought some of my very first sketch cards I think I ever did. But yeah, he's stuck with me through thick and thin. And I appreciate that, Brian. I like the piece. I think it came out really good. I had reference for another one of her, and I had a hard time choosing which one I did. I ended up choosing this one. I might go ahead and draw the other one too. That might happen in the next couple days, so. But yeah, I like this one because, the lines going across are kind of like when she walks down the steps and the steps have snow, you know. If you know the movie, she's kind of like walking down these steps from this big Japanese pagoda type thing, and there's like these giant samurai with like machine guns and stuff. Very cool. Anyway, I hope you like that one, Brian. What else we got? Of course, here's the Chewy piece, which I really think is cool, and a lot of people have been commenting, and liking a lot, and that's really neat. With that one, of course, I drew on the last video, so here it is done. There, there's a little bit more on the camera. I was looking at the camera, so hopefully I had the sucker punch piece on the camera. Then here's the other one that I think everybody's been wanting to see. This one on the left side picture. Really long. It's actually twice as long as. Let me see what kind of ground it is. Yeah, it's two of these. Whatever these ones are, I think they're 9 by 12, maybe? It's two of those. And it's actually a little different color paper. I think this one's called steel gray. This one might be called flannel gray. A little slightly different tone, but looks really good anyway. I might try a couple different tones, I don't know. But yeah, from a Maleficent movie, I haven't seen it yet. Definitely want to. But this was actually the when I did another Maleficent one, which was just a portrait. But this was the first one I found. And I thought, oh, I want to do that, but then I thought, it might be a little hard. Especially for like a, you know, one night kind of drawing. But yeah, I don't know. It wasn't that bad, and it's the kind of big piece I like. I like bigger pieces like this where they're still the figure's still small enough I feel like I can really concentrate on it. A lot of people have been kind of just, you know, they're always on me to do bigger stuff. But, you know, the reality is, like, I like to draw the size, so. I think I like to draw the size. I mean, a few days ago, I was kind of, actually got out a piece of this paper the size it comes. So it's, like, twice as big, you know. And I thought, I'm going to try something bigger. And I started drawing and scribbling and stuff, and it was coming out pretty good. But then I, like, realized it's, like, a lot of my technique and stuff. I mean, it's kind of a sloppy technique, I think. That's how I like to draw. But it's, you know, it's sloppy in a way that it's tight also, you know. And I think sometimes when I do it bigger, it's like it's just sloppy, and I'm not there enough in each section to tighten it down to where I want. And it never kind of takes that corner to being good in a way, you know. And I mean, maybe they're good and I just don't realize it, but anyway, that's this one's on eBay, I think. Chewy's on eBay, they both got bids. Hopefully I'll get some more stuff on eBay. I almost want to paint this Chewy one. I think that would make a really nice piece. I haven't really even got, I want to paint one of the Black Widows too. I just want to paint a bunch of stuff, I just haven't, I gotta get this guy in here, I gotta get this, Wolverine piece done and out the door before I can start painting again. But then I actually have a commission list developing already, and I'm not complaining about it. I'm super happy about it, and I appreciate the guys who have already got on there. But the next one is what is it? Oh, it's actually, well, I think you guys might have heard me talking about those Western posters. This is another Western poster for an indie film. It's not the same one as I did before. It's a different one and a different guy doing it. So, looking forward to getting on the sketches of that. I thought I'd be already doing them, but very soon I will be. And what's after that? I've got to do... I kind of hesitate telling you guys what they are, but one of them is a speeder bike, stormtrooper. That one's coming up. That's going to be a lot of fun. I got a really good idea for that one, or at least I think I do. We'll see what it looks like when I draw it. And got a DVD cover picture. I'll probably get that on film too. That's not movie art, but it's just, I mean, it's somebody's movie art, but it's not a famous movie, right? Who's after that? I'm trying to think. There's somebody else in there. I can't remember right now, but I'm sure it'll come to me. So. And I got an email last night, too, actually, from another guy who wants something, so. I don't know, things are going really well. I mean, I'm into the fourth week now, no job, and I tell you what, it's like I haven't once thought about, you know, maybe I shouldn't have done that. I've been too darn busy working like heck and figuring out what to do. And it definitely hasn't been easy, but it's working. And all my focus is on making it continue to work, which I think is pretty cool. And I don't know, I remember, what am I thinking about? Like, there was like a, somebody told me that Rocky story or something, like, you know, Sylvester Stallone, of course, wrote the first Rocky movie. He might have wrote them all, I don't know. But it was like when he was writing it, he wouldn't get a job because he didn't want to lose the hunger that, you know, not having a job gave him, basically. Literally hunger, you know, not being able to buy groceries and stuff. And he would have these big fights with his girlfriend. I don't know who his girlfriend was or if he ever married her or whatever, but they'd have these big, huge fights because the freaking heat would be turned off half the time and stuff like that. And she'd be like, why don't you just go get a job at a grocery store, you know? And he just wouldn't. And he'd be going on auditions and all these kinds of things that, you know, even when you get a job a lot of times in the movies, it doesn't pay anything right. And actually now I'm remembering this whole story. It was like you'd go to the library because the heat would be turned off and hang out in the library. And he saw, I think he was inspired by actually Edgar Allan Poe, like reading his poems. And he was inspired to try writing something. This was pretty amazing that Rocky's the first thing he writes. I wonder if that's true. I should check that out. But he's inspired to write something, which, you know, I mean, try telling that to your angry girlfriend when the heat's off. I'm actually going to be a writer, babe. Everything's going to be fine. That probably wouldn't go over well. So anyway, he writes the Rocky screenplay and he's shopping it around. And let me think, what else happens in that story? He gets so broke that the pay, and I'm pretty sure it was the heat, that he goes down to, like, you know, the local convenience store and he's got this dog. And he's like, I got nothing to get this money for the heat and I have to pay it. And he hangs out in front of the grocery store and he asks this guy if he wants to buy this dog. You know? And the guy's like, you're selling your dog? And he's like, yeah, I need like $50 to pay the heat. And the guy's like, just disgusted with him. He's like, that's the worst thing I've ever heard. You would sell your dog for $50, turn the heat on. And he gets so mad at him, he's just like, fine. And he just gives him the $50 and he takes the dog. He's like, you don't deserve this dog, dude. You're a horrible human being. And so he goes and pays the power and feels horrible that, you know, sold his dog, which, yeah, I would too, right? That's got to be the lowest of the low. And during this time, he's like submitting this Rocky script, shopping it around wherever he can. And he gets a bite from somebody. Probably the guys who made it, actually. I don't know who made it, 20th Century Fox or somebody. And they're like, man, you know, they call him in and they're like, you know, they're like, yeah, we love your script, man. It's great, you know. Like, we wanna buy it. I'm trying to think now. But it was like, I think they wanted to give him like $60,000 for it or some shit like that. Which is like, $60,000 when you just sold your dog to pay your heat is like awesome. And Stallone, who wanted to be an actor, was like, that's fantastic. And they're like, he's like, I got only one condition. That I play Rocky. And they're like, you can't play Rocky. And he's like, what do you mean I can't play Rocky? I wrote the part, blah, 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 you know, which is pretty crazy to think about it. Could you imagine anybody else playing Rocky? And They're like, you can't not play Rocky. And he's like, well, you can't have my script. Now just think of that. He just sold his dog. I mean, he's got no money, no job. What's he going to do? And this is probably like the only opportunity he's probably, you know, ever got. And who knows if he'll ever get another one. And he's like holding his ground. I'm not gonna budge unless you let me play Rocky. And I think they told him to go and take his script. And then they called him back later and was like, we want that script. What's it going to take? And he's like, I got to play Rocky. That's what it's got to be. And they still wouldn't let him do it. And they wanted, I remember who they wanted to play Rocky, which is just crazy. If you know who it is. But I couldn't even imagine that it would have been the same movie with this guy in it. Not that he's that bad of an actor, but I mean, you know, come on. Sylvester Stallone was Rocky Balboa. And they wanted Ryan O'Neal to play Rocky. You know, Ryan O'Neal was a popular actor back then. And, you know, and of course, you know, Stallone was like, no, it can't be him. It has to be me. And he wouldn't budge, and he wouldn't budge, and they're like, and finally he's like, look, you know, you're paying me $60,000 for this script. And I hope that number's right, I don't know, I just took a wild, I didn't take a guess, it's kind of like for some reason stuck in my mind. I'm sure you can find the story somewhere. But he's like, you know, just let me be in the movie, and you know, you pay me like $50,000. Just let me play Rocky. And they're like, no. So he starts going down. Gets down to $30,000. I think they might have finally relented at 30 grand. It might have been even a little lower. But I mean, he basically loses $30,000, which I'm, you know. It's like you just, I mean, it's like, I hate to harp on it, but you just freaking sold your dog because you can't pay the heat, and then now you're gonna like throw away another 30 grand. And so anyway, finally they he won't budge. They want the movie. He goes down and down on his price until finally they're like, all right, you can play Rocky. Just, you know, give us the script, get out of here. and so he does. He takes his money and he goes back to that gas station and hangs out there for days waiting for, hoping to see the guy he sold the dog to again. And I don't know how long he had to wait there, how long he staked out, you know, whatever, the local 7-Eleven or something. Finally, one day, guy drives up. He's got a dog in the side of his car, in a truck or something, a car. And there he is. And he goes up to him. He's like, man. He's like, look it. I have money now. I sold a script to Hollywood. I want to buy my dog back. The guy's like, what? He's like, I want to buy my dog back. You know, I gave him to you for $50. I'll pay $100 for him. And he's like, no way. You know, first you sell him because you don't have the money to pay your heat, which was despicable, and I thought you were terrible for that. And now you're trying to buy him back from me? And he's like, hell no, I'm not giving this dog for no amount of money. And so he starts going up on his price. And he's like, goes up to $500, and then he goes up to $1,000. And I don't remember in the story like what he gets to, but basically the guy won't even take any price, and he finally agrees to give him the dog back if he can have a part in Rocky. And he's actually in the movie. He's in the movie when he's in there punching the meat in the locker. I don't forget which guy he is, but that's what it cost him to get his dog back. I mean, you know, it's a funny story, but I mean, I don't know. I guess why I was thinking about it is because, you know, sometimes you just don't know if things are going to work or whatever, and you do stupid things. But, you know, just sometimes they work. Just because something hasn't worked doesn't mean it won't. You know, just because somebody hasn't done something doesn't mean that it can't be done. don't know. I just was thinking that because people say, you know, I've been saying, a couple of people have said that I've inspired them to do something, and, you know, that kind of story inspires me. I don't remember when I heard that story a long time ago, but I always kind of remembered it thinking, man, you know, that's ballsy, dude. You finally get somebody calling up for your script and you're like, I mean, I'm glad you're taking my script, but this is what it's got to be, you know, and you hang in there. Yeah, it takes some freaking nerve. And could you imagine? Could you imagine if he just sold it? I mean, he might not have, you know, I mean, if he was like the screenwriter on Rocky, even if Rocky was a hit, it, you know, I mean, he probably wouldn't have had the career that he had, you know, by just standing his ground and hanging in there, man. You know. Look what it did for him. And if it doesn't work, God, you know, then you're like the stupidest guy in the world, you know. You had a Hollywood movie deal, you know, and you passed it up just because you wanted a star in your movie. You know. And everybody would think you're an idiot. Anyway, well, anyway, there you go. I think I'm just going to wrap this one up because I need to start doing a little, shoot my airbrush in here and putting some white paint and running the hairdryer and all that kind of good stuff. And I just really want to concentrate on painting so I can get a long ways on this piece, get it done, so I can get on to the next one. And on to the next one, and on to the next one, and do all the really cool stuff that's coming. So I appreciate all the awesome comments, and I hope, you know, hope I can keep up with these videos, and hope it continues to inspire. So I'll see you guys next time.